When you become an ASEA Diamond Executive, you can buy your own island just like these two people did. These ASEA Diamonds, they live in Noosa and they do really work their business from their home on an island. Their passion is making a difference to people's lives and having a work-life balance that gives them joy and purpose. They live and breathe ASEA's ethos, which is in alignment with who they are. They have a clear vision for the future of ASEA and their team, which is to build a sustainable global business and to build people, empowering them to become their authentic self and enabling them to share ASEA with the world. These are two of some of the most beautiful ASEA Diamonds that I've met, inside and out. Would you please put a very warm welcome together for ASEA Diamond Executives, Sepp Hock and Jeske Maas. Come on! Take it in, but don't look down. Some on top of the world, eh? Some on top of the world, eh? I'm in for a while now. Pay my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to start all day.
All right. Hello. We're so excited to be here and we're so excited that you are all still here. This tremendous effort. Absolutely fantastic. Now, you can see we've both brought our pieces of paper just so that we remember what we want to talk about, but I think we'll be all right. The reading glasses, they're ready to go too. Now, we're going to share with you today a couple of concepts that really, they had a tremendous impact on us and on how we approach our business. And when we heard about these concepts, everything shifted for us. And so we're going to share this with you. I have no idea how this works. Which green button? Oh, that one. Okay. Now, so about this shift. Now, before I go into that, I actually, it's only a few weeks ago that our dear friend and fantastic, amazing mentor, Presidential Diamond, Denny Robinson, posted something on social media that so well describes what we're going to talk about today. And so that is, what is the real difference between a professional and an amateur? And she wrote, a professional can perform regardless of whether they're feeling inspired or not. And an amateur needs to feel inspired. Now, Emerson, he's a famous philosopher and poet in the United States of America. He said, do the thing and you shall have the power. And Denny Robinson continues to say that high performance people know that they need to create strategies to help themselves get into action, or ways to create the inspiration for themselves to get into action. They don't wait for inspiration. They don't wait for someone else to create excitement and momentum. They create it themselves. So today, our mission is to share with you a way and a possibility that you too can have a shift. And so that you can have a shift that you can say that building your ASEA business is worthy of your time. And that, yes, I can do this. Now, when we, I can tell you that we now, as Diamonds, we have created an income that really now matches the income that we used to have as very successful, sustainable builders. That is great. But what's really more wonderful is that the lifestyle that we have now is just amazing. But what brings us the greatest joy is the friendships, the people that we've met along the way and that we keep meeting all over the world. People that otherwise we would never have met. So that is something for us that is just truly, truly wonderful. Talking about these friendships and the people that we meet, I actually want to think about, maybe you want to do this with me. I want to ask you something. What do you think that when you get to the end of your life, what's the sort of question that you will ask yourself? Do you ask yourself, how much money have I made? Is that going to be your question? Or would you ask yourself, would you think about the experiences that you've had in your life? The rich and extraordinary experiences that you might have had in your life. Now you probably, I would say that's probably what I'll be thinking about. And these rich and extraordinary experiences probably with other people, with the friends that you've made. And I think, you know, the network marketing business gives us this amazing opportunity where we meet people all the time, make new friends, and with those new friends create extraordinary and rich experiences. And what's wonderful is that we get paid for that too, right? And that's really something that is so truly amazing. Over to you, I think. You want the clicker.
Moving on. So our mission here, or the mission of ASEA, we've heard it quite a few times, and I think if we practice it and by what we do every day and how we think and our pure intention, as Dr. Darren talks about, the power of intention is, you know, to better people's lives and be a force for good in the world. And really the simple act of kindness is actually reaching out to somebody, as we've heard from Tyler. But what's interesting is, we've touched on it yesterday when we did a presentation with Christina and I. You know, the world's going through a bit of a tough time on so many fronts, and I think we all agree that the most important thing in our lives would be our health. Would you agree? And just a show of hands, how much of us would agree that the most important thing is that we have our health? If we don't have our health, we can't really take care of others or make a difference. And so I would consider that the two foundational values in life would be our health, number one, because we all want to feel better and we all want to look better. Not look better, but we want to feel better about being healthy. The second one, you know, if we're really honest with ourselves and we can really connect with this one, and that's about finances or having money. And it's not so much having the money, it's what the money can do for us, but more importantly, it's about having peace around money. And I think once we can connect with that in our heart and being at peace with money and where that'll take us, that's where we can look at building a business and talk to people from a business point of view, or even sharing the opportunity. So how many people, just a show of hands, I'm going to ask two questions. You can put your hand up or not, you don't have to, but I think all of us in the room are going to be impacted by this. How many of us are either paying rent or paying a mortgage? Just a show of hands. And if we look around, I think it's pretty much all of us. So the interesting thing is, I was talking to a friend of mine the other day. He's a property developer here on the Gold Coast. I've been friends for 37 years. And he's gone into helping people get into homes and things like that. And, you know, if we compare what we're paying for our rent, he gave me some scenarios, and, you know, it's all very area specific. But the interesting thing is that for $550,000, you know, the return on that is going to be around $2,700 a month. Now, that could equate to $675, something like that a week. I'm not sure what rent you're paying or what mortgage you're paying. But the interesting thing about that is that if you had that sort of money, $550,000, and you're making a payment, What does that actually mean to our pocket? How many hours a week are we working? Are we working 40 hours, 60 hours a week? Is that times two? Is mum and dad doing that? Is someone else taking care of the kids? So the other scenario I wanted to share with you is that if you made an investment in the bank and you had $550,000 spare, I mean, I don't know who has spare 550 grand in their back pocket, and you invested that, and if you're lucky enough to get 2.3%, you would get, you know, $1,000 a month residual income. So the point I want to make here is about asset income with building as a professional, and standing in your own shoes with confidence and belief. I'd like to ask you, on a scale of 1 to 10, answer in your own mind, you know, what would it be like for the people that you're going to meet over the next 10 years? What would money mean to them? You know, to pay their rent, to be able to fix the car, to be able to take care of their families. And that's a really important question when we really get down to it. So, where am I going with that? A bit nervous, sorry. So this was the point I wanted to make, and this is probably the most important part. We've all seen, this is in our back office now, and I've circled the bronze. So this is in Aussie dollars. So $2,693 is the average bronze payment. Now think about what I just said before. Is it worthy of my time to build a network marketing business part-time, overtime, to be able to generate that? We're just talking about bronze, and that's average, right? These are Aussie dollars. What if your income could be paid for, sorry, your mortgage could be paid or your rent could be paid for over 3 or 4 years? Is that worthy of your time? And if you were earning that kind of money, that means you have an asset income worth that, you know, $500,000. It's extraordinary. When you start thinking about all of us Aussies in this room who are paying rent or paying mortgage, that's the equation we're talking about here. Is that worthy of my time? Will I get out of bed for that? And that's the point I wanted to make. This information, and another great mentors, we have quite a few in this industry that we follow, and Richard Bliss, Brooke, they're the books, the four-year career where this info is coming from, so we just wanted to honour them. So has anybody heard of compounding interest? So any bankers in the room or accountants? I know there's an accountant here somewhere. Albert Einstein said it's the eighth wonder of the world. And is Mel Sword in the room? He's probably not here, but you know, that's how rabbits multiply, cane toads multiply. So I'm not talking about Mel's kids, but because he calls them rabbits. But I just wanted to go there. So, but the point I'm making is that when it's done over and over and over again, that's what's happening. It's geometric compression or compounding. And it is the eighth wonder of the world. See, Thomas Wine. Okay, so then going into that, has anybody heard of the penny doubled?
Yeah.
So for those of you who haven't heard, can you just quick show of hands? Okay, if I offered you $100,000 cash right now, or 1 cent or a penny doubled every day for 30 days, which one would you take? The 100 grand, show of hands, right now, or the penny doubled? Okay, so does everyone know what that equation would look like? That's $5 million. That's compounding. Interesting. Now, the real interesting part of this is that if we're communicating this story in its truth, which is where probably most of us are at, if we double the penny or the cent doubled every second day, have a guess how much that's worth. You know, if I offered you 100 grand for that, or whatever that sum comes to, which one would you take right now, 100 grand or the penny doubled every second day? Every second day, show of hands? Okay, it's only actually worth $163. Amazing, isn't it? So that's the whole secret about compounding. And the interesting thing is that when we are approached from a prospect point of view and compounding, and you know, you can make money and it'll build over a period of time, there's a part of the equation that's really missing here, and this is where, when we got this, it really changed things. And we're at that point in our business where that compounding is already happening. And people think, oh, well, if I just do the business every other day or whenever, she'll be right, I'll pick up on half the business or half the income. And the interesting thing is that the reality is you'll probably end up with no business at all or no network. However, if you consistently stuck at doing one thing every single day, you could actually make a very huge network business. So for us, over 4.5 years, there are people coming into our organization every single week and we don't know who they are. So that's that whole compounding thing. So if imagine if you really went to work and did one single thing, and that's just asking people to have a look at the opportunity or the product every single day, once a day, and you compounded that over time, that's consistency in building your business. Three simple things to follow every single day, building your business, three fundamentals, and that's use the products. Use the products, recommend the products, and ask somebody to take a look. I'm just keeping it really simple. We're running out of time, so I'm going to hand it over to Jessica.
Thank you. All right, so I'm now going to focus on the psychological part of this, and really how to that's something that can get you step off the curb and pick up the phone and really engage with someone in conversation. Now, keep this in mind about the penny double and every other day that you really don't have much of a network, or every other day that it only gets you $170 instead of, you know, millions. So I'm going to ask you a few questions and really think about, even when you commit to building your business, you're going to have days where you're going to have a bad day, you're going to have a low day, you procrastinate, you lose traction, and you just, you know, you really don't feel like it. But know that you can create excitement and action for yourself. So I want you to imagine this hypothetical. And so just put yourself in this movie. The CEO, the company, is going to change the rules. They're going to change the compensation plan. Well, really, they are going to add a bonus. And this bonus is really quite something. ASEA has finally figured out that what the primary core activity is, and that's inviting people, not every other day, not when we feel like it, but every day. So imagine we all went out and invited just one person every day, 6 days a week for 1 year. Here's the new bonus ASEA has put into place. So for 1 year, they're going to pay you $500 every day, as long as you invite at least one person to take a look at the business opportunity, which also includes the products, of course. And so it's got to be a package deal, product and business opportunity. Then, and you're just going to invite them to take a look. When you do that, one person to take a look, you get $500 a day. Okay, so what that means is that you're going to invite them to take a look. They don't have to come to a presentation. They don't have to say yes. They don't have to say maybe. They don't have to say no or anything like that. You're just going to ask them to have a look. And they need to say yes that they're going to have a look, or no, or maybe, but they don't have to join. So there's no. There's no commitment there, really. As long as you invite someone to take a look, and there is a conversation. So you can't just send them a text. You can send them a text, but they need to respond with, yes, I'll take a look, no, I won't take a look, or maybe I'll take a look. Now, if you do that, you will actually be getting, if you do that every day, you'd be getting $500, $12,000 for the month. How would that feel? Would that make a difference? Feel that one, sit with that. And now, do know that if you miss a day, you were tired, the kids had soccer, you couldn't find your list, you didn't feel well, just didn't feel like it, or you just forgot, what happens? You get terminated. You don't get your $500 and you get terminated. Now, not only that, you don't get back in. That's it, you're done, out. So, would you agree to that deal? Now, more importantly, could you do it?
Yes.
Awesome. Yeah, So then sit with that for a bit. Invite one day, you get $500 if you do that every day. Invite at least one a day. Now, what would happen if you actually nailed that? I know I need to finish. Have I got three more minutes? I'm just going to keep going because I don't want to let you hang on this one. Okay, so now imagine you nailed that. What if you really nailed that? You got that happening. Now, who would you talk to? Think about this. Who would you talk to? Everyone? Right. That's what I first said too, but really there's a distinction. There is a distinction. I think you really need to think about anyone. How would that feel? Anyone. Because really, when you think about it, the waiter in the cafe with a bad attitude, you might ask the waiter with the bad attitude. You could choose to do so, but would you? You don't have to. So it's not everyone, it's anyone. Or think about your lazy neighbor that lies on the couch all day, watches TV, drinks beer, smokes cigarettes, and is cranky. You probably wouldn't ask him. So you can ask anyone, and you have a choice who you'd like to ask. So think again, anyone you can ask, and you just have to ask them to take a look, and they give you an answer. Engage in the conversation. Now, question two. I'm going way ahead of my time. So think about that. You feel how do you feel about that? There really then comes in so for $500 a day, at least one invite a day for 6 days a week for a year, that would give you, probably, I could hear a lot of people go here, it gives you a sense of peace and clarity and power and confidence. If you felt a little bit scared, then that's okay too. And the richness, the feeling of the clarity, just the fact that you can talk to anyone, that is when we, as a professional, that is exactly how we go about it. But really, what do you say? What do you say to a person if you get paid $500 a day and it doesn't really matter? You just say hi and strike up a conversation. If you don't know the person, you don't know what to say yet, because you have to get to know them first. So there's no scripts necessary for people that you don't know. Also, of course, because it doesn't really matter, as long as you ask them to take a look and they say yes, no, or maybe, you're going to get that $500 a day. So I'm going to finish up here. And so you think about this. You can talk to anybody, and this is exactly how we approach our business as a professional. And I'm going to finish up now. So when you can approach just about anybody, there is that feeling of possibility, of engagement, and you're creating friends, you're making friends, because you have a conversation with just about anybody, and you're creating connection. Now imagine how that would feel, and imagine what you could build.
Thank you.
Someone's up with the most.